Rural roads account for the majority of road deaths, for just 42% of the distance travelled. Accidents on these roads frequently involve a loss of control and can happen where there are no other vehicles involved. Crashes are often at speeds which are below the statutory limit, so a different speed benchmark is needed. Most studies show that the risk of a vehicle's involvement in a serious accident increases exponentially in relation to the variance from the mean speed of free-moving traffic. There are other factors which have an influence too, and of these, fatigue is particularly relevant to fleet drivers. Rosper states that one of the most significant risks your staff face and create is driving at inappropriate speeds on work-related journeys, and this is why we developed our SafeSpeed database. It gathers 30 million data points from fleet vehicles every day and maps them against more than 1 million road segments. These distributions are used to provide a better way of measuring accident risk with your drivers. Here are a few distributions from the SafeSpeed database. They're generally below the 60 mile an hour speed limit on rural roads, as you can see. In fact, on this final one, you can see that all recorded data points are well below 60 miles an hour. The best way to understand why the speed limit is such a poor measure of risk on country roads is to drive one. This one goes from Barrington to Foxton near Cambridge. It's typical of a rural 60 mile an hour road. I'll speed up the straight parts and focus on the hazards, starting with the first bend. I had to slow down to 24 miles an hour for that. That's followed by a level crossing with uneven road surface, and then another right-angle bend where speed dropped under 30 miles an hour again. The right speed for this road is certainly not 60 miles an hour. So this is how we would score a fleet driver for that short road section. Here's the speed distribution, which shows the depth of data we have in the SafeSpeed database. We apply no penalty below the mean speed, but then a steady increase in score up to the 75th percentile, followed by a steeper rise in weighting through to the highest score at the 95th percentile. This is far more appropriate than using the 60 mile an hour speed limit, as there are virtually no vehicles travelling that fast on this stretch of road. If you would like more information about driver scoring using the SafeSpeed database, or a copy of our white paper on reducing speed risk in your company, please call or email us. Thank you.